the set, we're on the train on the way home, he goes, Paul, look what I've got here. And then we'll see the meaning of this. This is what they drink, and it turns them into crazy things, as you'll see in the film. We're delighted to invite loads of the cast, and of course the director. First of all, Mr. Bernard Pichet. Come on down, Bernard. He's a good guy. Record label staff and all that malarkey.
See that again?
And who have you got with you?
I've got my producers, Michael and Raymond. Please come up here. These guys have been the absolute troopers of this whole thing. They've been absolute
troopers. Don't fall on the stage.
I've also got my main cast with me. I've got Georgia Hirst.
Hey, from my thing to stop. She's amazing.
I've got
fabulous in the same moment.
Maria Volk.
Hey.
I've got Manpreet, Bambra. I've got my Dutch giant.
Oh my god! The tallest man on the FrightFest.
I've got Tom Spink.
The smartest man on the FrightFest.
And I've got my creative confidant, Lou Foster, my writer.
He's
the guy that got all of us, so he's a man. And last but not least, I've got Kamal, Angelo, Bolden with me as well.
The full Ravers contingent.
Yes, it is. I managed to bring everyone.
So, I said about the Welsh thing and stuff. Tell us how you got to this position, as in with here, with the movie.
It was the development thing was a 5-year process. It took a long time just to get the script written and made and then financed and all that stuff. That took quite a while. We had a 6-week shoot in Cardiff, which was a crazy experience then, because we had, remember the 2 days snow that we had, our shoot got shut down, even though all that happened. Then when we were hoping to get into FrightFest, but we didn't know if we'd get in, so we were working our ass off to try and get it done, and when we found out we got in, we were like, oh my god, we have to be done now. So our post-production schedule, which was supposed to be 8 months, turned into 5. So that meant cram, 24 days, et cetera, up until 4 a.m. in the morning of Saturday, a week ago. You know, so it's been a mental ride.
When me and Alan saw it about 3 or 4 weeks, you were like, we love it, you have to finish it. We haven't seen the finished version. This literally was like a day or two ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we managed to do the final export at 4 o'clock in the morning on the weekend.
But what was really cool on the set, apart from obviously knowing you guys, was Dan Martin does some of the special effects in this.
He's really good stuff.
The brilliant Melanie Light, again, a good friend of ours, she works on it as well. And Peter Padero, the stunt guy. So it's a really, it was like the FrightFest crew were there.
Absolutely.
It was amazing.
It was a great crew.
And the cast were brilliant. George was the toughest.
Completely agree.
Good times. So.
Yeah, thanks. It's, I'm so excited for you guys to see it. I hope you guys have a great time with it. And it's a labor of love for me as a DJ. I've always wanted to make a movie that treats technology and stuff like that properly and still opportunity to set it against the horror film as well. It's just the opportunity of a lifetime. I couldn't possibly ask. Because that is your background, isn't it? Yeah, I mean, I was a DJ, started at 16 in the 90s, of course, the peak time of the rave culture, in my opinion. But I'm glad that it's now gotten this massive resurgence with these massive festivals like Tomorrowland and Ultra and all these things. So it's great that it's a huge part of the culture and a part of the mainstream culture. I'm very happy about that. But we decided to focus on decided to focus on sort of the underground illegal rave squat parties, that kind of thing. And I used to play squat parties a few times. So and even while I was DJing, I thought, what if shit went wrong now? Yeah, I mean, like if something went terribly bad. This would go absolutely terrible. When Luke came to me with the idea for having a horror film with where ravers take something bad and they turn mad,
I was like, "This is the
perfect opportunity."
Bad drink, the energy.
Yeah, that's the, you know. It was just a perfect opportunity to write and develop something that I could really grind my teeth into and bring my experience to. And it's been wonderful. It's been great.
That's cool.
And you guys want to say anything about the shoots or anything like that?
It was a great experience shooting in Wales. The snow was fine. Canadian side refused to leave it to shut down production. But no, the cast were really came together. It was a pretty intense shoot. We packed it all into 6 weeks, which it's hard to think back on. We got everything done, but we did. And it was a really great experience. I haven't seen the finished film at all yet.
Me neither.
Yeah, I haven't seen it, so I'm pretty excited. Thanks to the fans for coming out.
Yeah.
You enjoy it.
And also, I have to say, as a lover of horror, I always wanted to know what it was like to be in a horror film. I used to watch horrors and be like, they must be really sad. And now I've lived it, I know, I'm not going to tell you the answer. I now know the answer for myself. Thanks to all you guys for coming. We really, really appreciate it. No pressure! Ravers was quite an experience. We had a lot of fun.
We did.
Even with the snow, it was. I was happy because I hadn't seen snow in like 15 years.
I love how snow is the thing we all remember. So many other things.
How much fun did we have with that snow?
We did.
It was just really freaking great experience. And Bernard was amazing. Such a great director. And the cast and producers and everyone was just amazing and super wonderful. We just had a lot of fun. Yeah. And we made it out alive. Some of us didn't, but you have to wait to find out and see. We didn't. But physically,
we
were.
Thank you all for coming today. I'm really excited for everyone to see it. It was an amazing experience. I learned so much. I think we all got along really well, so we had so much fun. So it's lovely to do a job where you actually enjoy it and you have fun. And I love horror, but I like getting scared. It's really weird, but I just watched it, and Bernard watched me watch it, I think. And he was like, Nanny, I should have videoed your facial expressions. It's amazing. It's so different to do a horror film and then actually watch it. And it was the best experience. I learned so much. And I still got scared, even though I didn't. So, you know, it was an experience. But yeah, thank you so much. I really hope you guys will enjoy it.
Good. My name is... I'm Max Kamal. I'm Suzanne. They call me the Dutch Giant, and Bernard called me today, really needed a giant. And I read the script, and I said, yes, I want to do this for my first international movie. I haven't seen it yet, so I'm very excited to see it. And thank you all again, Ravers team, for giving me this chance.
Yeah, I think going back of what Manny said, it was great to work with the cast. We all got along really well, and the environment on set was just so lovely, and joining that slightly later was a massive privilege, and it was so professional. It was great. It was great to be part of, and I hope you guys enjoyed.
I'm a big horror fan. I've actually been here for the whole festival. I've been sitting up here watching all the other movies for the last couple of days. I'm still just recovering from watching the Pascal Larrier film last night. So I'm just really looking forward to seeing Ravers on the screen in here, and then hopefully everyone will really enjoy it.
Again, I want to echo thank you for all coming out. This is the first, many firsts for me, first time being over in Europe, from Peoria, Illinois. States of America, it's our first time shooting a horror film. It's the first time, I was about to give away something.
Don't!
It's another first, you'll find out. Yeah, it's a lot of different firsts. But I would say one of the craziest experiences was working in this genre and applying like our acting techniques to the horror genre. So like trying to literally come up with like a method way of doing things at a rave party that you normally would just take for granted. And it was awesome working with Bernard and the whole team, and everybody was extra creative in this whole film. Thank you.
All I can say is I hope you enjoy Ravers. These guys will be here afterwards. Obviously not for the Q&A, we don't do Q&A's anymore. They'll be here all afternoon. Thank you so much. Enjoy Ravers!